This is chapter number 3, ratio and proportion, and under this we are going to study chapter 8, percentage and its application. From here, percentage, it is symbolically written as in this way. Okay, what does percentage means? What does percentage means? Percentage mean in every 100 or per 100. In every 100 or you can say per 100. Okay, firstly percentage, the symbol of percentage is this, and it means in every 100 or per 100. One note you have to write down here, that a fraction can be expressed in terms of percentage and decimal. Okay, so your note is there, a fraction, it can be expressed in the terms of percentage also or in the terms of decimals also. So first, if I write an example, 3/4, this will be equal to 75%. If we will take out the percent for this, this will be equal to 75%, or I can write down this as 0.75 in decimal. Okay, a note is there, a fraction, it can be expressed in the terms of percentage or decimal. This is a fraction here, and if I have to take out the percent, it will be 75%, and when I will take out the decimal form of 3/4, it will be 0.75 in decimal. Now the second topic is profit and loss. Here in this topic, first we will study the term cost price and the second term is selling price. Okay, what is cost price here? Means suppose the price for which an article is bought. Let's take the price for which
selling selling price here. Now your condition is there. Condition for profit. When you will get profit and when you will get loss. The second is loss. Profit you can say gain also. Okay. So what is the condition? And profit, the selling price. The selling price. Price will be greater than the cost price. So then you will be in the profit, means selling price at which you are selling the article, that will be greater than the cost price. Suppose here you have purchased a table at rupees 600 and sold it for 150. Means see the condition. You have purchased it with 600 and you are selling with 150. So is this the condition for profit? No, because here your cost price is greater than the selling price. For the condition of profit, what it should be? Selling price should be greater than the cost price. So the profit, so if this is the condition of loss. So similarly, for the loss, selling price, cost price. Okay, for the loss, what is the condition? Here the cost price will be greater than the selling price, then you will have loss. See, the cost price is greater than the selling price. So in this condition, what you are getting? You are getting a loss of how much rupees? So let's take out. This is the cost price and this is the selling price. Okay, so what is the cost price here? 600 rupees. And what is the selling price here? 150 rupees. So practice, you will get 54. So 450 rupees you are getting here as loss, because here the cost price is greater than the selling price. So this is the condition of loss. So how much loss he had? Rupees 450.
So what we were studying, profit and loss condition. So what is the formula for profit? Formula for profit will be selling price minus cost price. This is the formula for profit when the condition is that the selling price is greater than the cost price. Similarly for loss, loss is cost price minus SP, selling price, because here the condition is that the cost price is this greater than the selling price, then it is loss. If selling price is greater than the cost price, then it is profit. If cost price is greater than the selling price, that is loss. Now one thing you have to note down, you have to find out the profit percent and loss percent. So here one note is there. Here one note is there that profit and loss percent is calculated on the cost price. Profit or loss percent, profit percent or loss percent is calculated on the cost price. Profit and loss percent will be always calculated in the cost price. This is very important. Note down this, because while solving the question, this term will be used. This is the formula for profit percent. Profit, whatever profit you have got, upon CP into 100. Okay, what is the formula for taking out the profit? From here you will take out the profit. Whatever profit you will take out, you have to take out the profit percent also. So that profit upon the cost price into 100. In this way you can find out the profit percent. Similarly, what will be the formula for loss percent? This will be loss upon CP into 100. That means loss percent will be taken out by this formula. Whatever loss you have to find out, with this formula you will find out the loss, and for loss person it will be loss upon CP into 100. So very important note is there, profit or loss percent is calculated on the cost price. This is very important. Okay, now the next portion is that an article is bought for rupees 1000, means bought means you are purchasing. That means this is the cost price. Cost price is how much? 1000, and sold for rupees 1250. That means selling price is how much? 1250. From here you can see which is greater, selling price or cost price. So here you see that selling price is greater than the cost price. So what, in which is, what is the condition here? What are you getting, profit or loss? See, I have told you what condition you are getting. Selling price is greater than the cost price, then which condition? This is the condition of profit. So how you will take out the profit? You will minus selling price minus cost price. So you will subtract, this is the selling price minus the cost price. So what is the answer here? Here you will get 250 rupees as the profit percent. Now what you have to find? Profit percent. So how you will find out the profit percent? Profit upon cost price. So what is the profit? 250 upon what is the cost price? 1000 into 100. So this and this zero gets cancelled, this zero and this zero gets cancelled, this zero and this zero gets cancelled. So what is the profit percent? 25%. This is the answer. Similarly, in the next question it says, a chain was bought for rupees 800. Bought means here you are getting the cost price. Cost price is how much? 800 rupees. And you sold it for 600, means your selling price is how much? 600 rupees. Check the condition. Here you can see that selling price is greater than the cost price. Cost price is greater than the selling price. So what is the condition here? When cost price is greater than the selling price, that means that is you are in loss. So how you find out the loss here? Loss is equal to, what is the formula for loss? Cost price minus selling price. So from here, 800 minus 600, that is 200 rupees. You are at rupees 200. So how you will find out the loss percent? Loss percent is equal to, what is the loss? 200 rupees upon cost price. What is the cost price here? 800 into 100. This zero gets cancelled, this zero and okay. So here you will get with 200 by 8. Now the next topic is, what is mark price, discount and net price here. So what is the definition of mark price? The printed price or the tag price of an article is called the mark price. Suppose you went to Big Bazaar and you purchased a jeans there. There you have seen a label on that particular cloth, it is there. So one tag is there, in that it is written this much price. Okay, so that is the mark price or the tag price of that particular jeans. Now what is discount? So understood what are the actual price printed on that tag or tag price, that is known as the mark price. So now we have to know, what do you mean by discount? Discount is the deduction allowed on the mark price is called a discount. Okay, suppose you are given with 1000 rupees is given as mark price. Okay, so now what is discount? The deduction allowed on the mark price means on this mark price, suppose you are getting 10% discount. Okay, on this mark price you will get 10% discount. So this is given on the mark price. Remember that the discount is given on the mark price, that is printed on the label or in the tag. Now what is the third one? Third one is the net price. Net price means the selling price at which the article is sold to the customer after deducting the discount means what is net price here. Net price means that this was marked price after getting after getting 10% discount, okay, on the marked price, the amount which you have to pay, that is the net price. This is marked price, this is discount, and after getting 10% discount on the marked price, whatever amount you have to pay, that is the net price of that jeans. Okay, so understood what is marked price, what is discount, what is net price. Marked price is also known as list price or listed price, okay, and discount is generally given in percentage. So here are the some formulas which will be useful while solving the question. So for today, just note down these formulas. When you will solve the question one by one, you will go through the formula, and this formula will be very useful, and you will understand the concepts at that time. So note down these formulas. So here what is given, selling price is equal to, when you have to find out the selling price, so you will subtract mark price from the discount, then you will get what you will get the selling price from here only, you can see. Okay, now what is the second one, rate of discount. So from here you can find out discount percent will be taken on the mark price, discount upon mark price into 100, like we find out the profit percent, or that profit upon cost price into 100. So this will be calculated on the mark price. Similarly, the next is selling price is equal to mark price into 100 minus discount percent upon 100, and again mark price is equal to 100 into SP upon 100 minus discount. For the today, just note out the formulas. When we will solve the exercise, you will go through the formulas at that time, you will understand this.